So, I'm a web developer, right? But I really liked the idea of this decentralized system the first time I read about it. So instead of going the traditional route of learning the specific blockchain language Solidity and trying to understand how to program smart contracts, I recently started pioneering on the blockchain OS, using the existing software stacks and libraries we're used to. Anything you can do on Linux, you can do on the blockchain, basically. For a mainstream web developer like me, this was essential. I wanted to make a decentralized ride-sharing application. Think of it like an alternative Uber app, but democratic in nature. A geofence defines the boundaries for a journey, and any deviation from that zone incurs a penalty fee for the driver. This system could be supported by shared governance, like a decentralized autonomous organization, so that the community can decide what the commission is for each ride. The fact that we can already think about future applications is because the blockchain OS made it easy to build. I can, for instance, use existing geo-processing Python libraries. I'm a web developer with no prior blockchain experience, and I didn't have previous Python experience either. But I had to do geofencing processing with GPS positions in Python. So I didn't make it easier for myself. But the blockchain OS allowed me to prototype this application really fast. I was able to import an existing geofencing Python library that took care of a lot of the processing I had to do. I was just talking about how I was able to get started to write code really fast on the blockchain OS. Because without the OS, I'd need to learn Solidity. I would take a really long time learning it, and then another really long time trying to express what I wanted in the code. Now I didn't have to deal with any lower level details of blockchains. I just started coding. Of course, the bi-weekly sessions with the Cartesi team helped, but it's pretty easy for a Web2 developer to get started on the OS. So basically, inside the Cartesi machine, you have to write code that interacts with the blockchain, right? But on Cartesi's framework, they abstract that difficulty so that you don't really have to understand the intricate behavior of the blockchain. The blockchain OS abstracts that for you. And in order to provide a more familiar interface to the developer, they made a choice of having the interface inside the Cartesi machine be an HTTP interface, which a lot of web developers are used to, right? Because a lot of web developers do microservices back-end using HTTP. All sorts of APIs are compliant with HTTP. So onboarding on the blockchain OS and developing your first application is pretty straightforward. I think that blockchain will be the main technology for the future. It can be applied in many fields of our lives. Our government here in Vietnam is trying to apply blockchain in education and in the public transportation system. So I think that it's going to be the most powerful and the most important technology for the future. The new voting DApp we're building now, it really has a way to change things in society, right? If we want to bring that decentralized Uber application to the world, with DAO governing it in the future, it will be different from the centralized system we have today, in which basically Uber takes a big part of the profit of the driver. We can have a more meaningful system in which people can just say, okay, so the commission's too high, let's lower it. So instead of having someone dictating the commission to you, you can just have it fluid and go according to the community needs.